potion. So I've removed the rocker cover to change this end push rod. Because when I did it running in the last video, you all have seen it was twisted. Don't really want it to fail. Put the valves into the pistons or something exciting like that. That's just compression. Turn the engine over a bit. One's going down now, so shouldn't be compression on it now. Need for set. I don't know if that got bent. Oh, you can see, you can actually see the bend on it if you look along that way. Maybe got bent when the engine was in a poorly state, and it wasn't a poorly state. This is the second one I've replaced. I'm going to make sure it's sitting on the camphor. Looks good. There's 12 exhaust, 15 intakes, so number one's down, so that's my roll of 9. Just getting a bit to go yet, of course she's in the near tight. This is where it was. About 12,000. 15 Okay. safe. We're going to start her up and put her outside. Let's get a quick start and make sure that's looking good. No cold start, and it's about 1 degree. Might put the exhaust back on before we do that. Right, I'll bring you back once we get the tractor outside. I've got the tractor outside now. Try and get the temperature to come up. So reset the valves when it's at 80 degrees. Just going to leave it running until the temperature gauge comes up. End rocker now, it's not bent like it was before, so the end push rod doesn't seem to rotate like the other ones either. Had to use the cold start to get it to go. Right, we'll leave that for a wee while. The book says to run it up to 180 degrees Fahrenheit and then reset your tappets. Same sizes, 12 and 15. 12 for the exhaust, 15 for the intake. See if I can count to 9 today. 6 in exhaust, so that's in the 12. Be interesting to see if they're all a bit tighter. Okay, that's 6. Dimension of it. Two's down, so it can be 7. That's 6, that one. 7 is intake, so it's 15. Sheet under. Yeah, that's fair. This is down. 7. Seven's down, so I can do 2 and it's an intake, so that's 15 again. That's okay. That 7's down again, would you believe? Back to where it was. Six is input. 15. Tight. pulleys and the hand brake should turn off the tire. And then in the middle. Seven, so we can do two, which is what? Might have done it already, actually. Okay. Seems to be the just exhaust ones that I've been tweaked a wee bit. One's down, so we can do 8. Just 10. That is 2, 4, 6. 6 and 3, which is 8 o'clock. And what? Okay. I don't know. So we've done 4 over. Maybe. Finds to be done. And that's exhaust, so that'll be 5th. Yeah, come out. And this one. Yeah, it's good. I think that's them all. You can leave me a message if I've missed one, but they're all pretty nearly there anyway. This gasket's a wee bit cracked, but I'm just going to leave it just now in case I have to do any other modifications. My lash cap seems to be standing up anyway. Slightly bigger than other ones. It's the same inside, but it's got more wall thickness. It's working. Let's see if she'll just start over here. There we go. When you take the push rods out, there's always like a polished surface on them, so maybe that's caused by that rotation. I don't know if that's correct or not, but that new one's not doing it. It's working, so then we don't worry about it. Got a bit of oil come out, but I think we'll not. So that's today's job done. Got a bit of welding to do on here sometime. Not doing much else, it's quite icy to do. I need to blow up the front tyre at the other side, it's going down again. Apart from that, that's all we're doing. So thanks for watching, bye for now.